have this cute candle burning, and then I have some music going on. So I'm just trying to get in the zone because I've just been feeling like not the best lately, and I want to feel like my best self. I'm gonna take off my makeup later because earlier I went to a lunch. I'm gonna take off my makeup. Bought these towels. I wanted to show the camera because I feel like just sometimes when you're always on the go, 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 you don't really have time to like really think and talk about what you're going through, you know what I mean? Took a 2-month break from working, felt like I was like retired for a little bit there. I was really just living life and just doing me. I just really had no fucks given. And now I'm just excited to get back into my zone. I do that a lot. I sometimes like take months off at a time, which I don't know if that's like the healthiest thing, to be honest, because when you do that, it honestly kind of feels like the focus is lost. But at the same time, when you are really, really focused, it's just easier to get back into it. So I thrive in a really good environment. Like when I'm in the right environment, I feel like I thrive really well. So I'm just happy to be back into my zone so I can feel like I'm thriving again. So I am in the US. And I will probably be here for the rest of the month. I don't know about the rest of the summer. I will be going back in August for Joanne's wedding, which is my first girlfriend in my group who's getting married. So I'm so excited. I really want to get married soon because, but to get married, you have to have a boyfriend. And then to have a boyfriend, you have to be nice and be open to men and actually be receptive to the things that they do. And I don't know if I'm already on that. I've been single for a good year. I wouldn't say fully single. Of course, I was like dating around and stuff, but I just really was a different version of myself during the time I was dating, and I didn't recognize her. So I wanted to take a break from dating, and I was just dating for fun, and it was just like not, it was just got really messy sometimes. So I definitely don't want to do that again. I'm just gonna put on some makeup because I have a dinner later, and then we're going to Mesa, which is like a lounge, and then I'm gonna sleep early because I have things to do tomorrow, and I'm just gonna take it easy. I'm probably not gonna like drink or anything crazy tonight. I'm gonna try to bring you guys because I feel like it's so hard to vlog when you're like actually out, you know, because there's just like so much going on, and I want to be able to be present, to enjoy and have fun, but at the same time also vlog because I want content. So it's like always a struggle. I'm using the Dior foundation. I've been using this foundation for a really long time. So I always come back to it because I like this one and the MAC one. I really rarely ever wear foundation. I would say I wear foundation probably once every week or once every 2 weeks. I really rarely use it. I just wear concealer and then powder on top because my skin is very sensitive and I don't want it to be super, super crazy. So I'm gonna get ready because I definitely want to take a photo. I want to get back on the feed. Isn't it so crazy that when you start giving someone chances and then you realize that you finally put yourself first, you no longer want that person, and then they start running back and doing these things for you, and it's like, bro, you had me at the version that I wanted you and then you didn't appreciate it, and then now you want me when I'm so over it. That's literally how I feel right now. Like, I invested so much of my energy and feelings into somebody, and then it wasn't reciprocated for a while, and then by the time that it was reciprocated, I was already over it. I'm like, this is not it. That's why it's so important to be consistent, and that goes with everything. I feel like now I'm at a place where I just want to refocus myself on the business and realign. Like, whoever doesn't realign with that part of me, they can literally just go away, because I don't want to be that person anymore who's like distracted. I don't want people who distract me. And like, it's all fun and games in the moment, but afterwards it just gets so exhausting. Like, why do I want to be in that kind of situation, you know? Like, I don't want to be a distracted person. I want to be a person who's like traveling good, eating good, being with a boyfriend or a husband, and like living a really good life. And it's a private life, but also enjoying every moment, and also being able to still make content and work. And like, I don't want to be with a person who distracts me from working and tells me don't work, or tells me to like stop doing the business. Like, what the heck? This is like your baby. And I feel like I have a soft spot for people when I grow feelings with them. So anything that they do, it just really puts me, it makes me feel like, oh, it's fine, even though it's not, you know? And I don't like that version of me, because I want to be with a person who brings and elevates you. And that's what it is with the right relationship. They're supposed to want to elevate you and make you your best self. But when they're not, it's so difficult. And I don't want to just keep settling for less. So I'm in my I choose me era, and I'm in my, you know, I'm kind of over the villain era. Like, that was like fun and games, and I'm just like over it now. But I'm in my I choose me era. I choose peace. I choose growth over many things. And so I'm going to just continue to be the proper self that I can be. So that's kind of like my thought process right now. I don't really know what else to say, but I'm just in an era where it's like, I'm gonna just do me, you know? And if you don't align with that, or if you don't wanna be there, or you don't wanna be that person, it's totally fine. Go separate ways, be cool, be cordial, be friends. Like, not everyone you date is gonna be that person, you know? It's just your turn for that time only. And I think I realized that with many of the guys I've dated in the past year. It's just like a learning lesson. And I'm a very picky person too, on top of that. So when I do end up coming, letting somebody come around my energy, I just feel like that's a big investment on its own already. So I'm just in a place of like rebuilding myself and my business. And I was retired for a little bit there. I'm back to ready to get back to work. I'm ready to be back to my best self and feel like, you know, the world is aligning. And I feel like that. Today was the first day I woke up in 3 months and I was like, I feel like I'm realigning my values and my beliefs into who and where I want to be, because there's many things I want to do before I'm 30. I'm already 27. I just turned 27. And I just turned 27 like a few weeks ago, and it's crazy because like now I'm considered late 20s, which is like, what the fuck? Who the fuck wants to be late 20s? Like, ew. But it's fine. I'm excited to get to that place, and I just have so many things I want to do before I'm 30, and one of them is building and having a family with somebody that I truly care about. But to do that, you have to find somebody to be your boyfriend, and then they have to, you know, put a ring on it and all these things. But it's like, am I at that place where I want to be? Am I at my best version of myself? I have to ask all of these questions, you know? And don't date for potential, girls. So many girls, yes, I'm fucking talking to you. Date for potential. Like, stop dating men. Date them where they are and leave them where they are. If that's not what you like, you know? Who they are now is who they are. It's not who they're gonna be. It's about who they are right now. And so again, I'm just going through that like totally resurfacing and redirecting self phase. But I'm excited. At first I didn't want to come back to the US so soon. I was right here for like a year, and then I took a break coming back for like 6 months, and then now that I'm back here, I'm kind of like, oh, maybe I won't want to come back right now. But I just realized that I like it when I'm here. I thrive when I'm in the right environment, because it's so easy to get into the wrong environment, and then when I'm in the wrong environment, it gets really messy, because then I don't know what I'm doing, where I am, and it just like, it's not a good time. But now I feel like I'm in a better place. I need just like better people around me, a better headspace to make the right decisions, because otherwise you just get really messy, and then you don't really know like what you're doing. And it's just like, for someone like me, when I'm into a new environment and new people and new things, I love it. I love meeting new people, and then it just drives me into different direction, and then it just kind of gets dangerous when you don't know when to stop, and that can just get like a spiraling downhill. So it's not good if you don't know where you are. But I feel like I'm in a better place today, and I'm just excited for what's to come for the month. I have my one-on-one mentorship opening again soon. I took a break from that since April, and I had closed and sold out all my seats when it was in November last year, so I'm excited to relaunch that. We also aren't doing any more in-person classes for the summer, so if you guys missed out on that, it's a snooze you lose situation. But that's totally fine, because I still have my online program, which is the free one, where you can go into the class, sign up for free. It's a 1 hour link down below. You guys can take a look at that if that's something of your interest. And that's just literally me teaching you guys how to be able to live a laptop lifestyle, you know? Like, I'm not doing MLM, I'm not doing like selling vitamins, things like that. Like, of course those are great things as well, don't get me wrong. I think anything that you want to do in your life can make money online passively, but it's a matter of like things that you want to build and sustain. And for me, I like long-term vision, long-term growth, long-term building of life. And for me, I will not be able to put myself into a long-term investment if I can't see myself growing with that place or thing or company of 10 years plus. And that's the best thing, is that like when you build a brand for yourself, you know you can depend on yourself. You're dependable, you know? You only have you for the rest of your life, and you're the person that you're growing old with, and you're your longest commitment. So why not build a company under you? You're the best bet. So I always think of it that way. It's like when you're building a company of yourself and your own brand and for you, and something that you stand for, something that you love, and something you can represent, You never run out of ideas. You never run out of money. You never run out of discipline to work hard. You don't want to, you just never run out of the growth and like the life of saying like, oh, I don't want to work today. But like, it's like you're working for yourself and this is your brand. This is you. Of course you're going to work today, because if you don't show up for yourself, who will? And when you get into that mind space of knowing that you can build a brand for yourself and whatever that you do, you can be successful if you're in the right framework, then it just gets so much easier. So I'm at that place right now in my life that I am just so excited to see so many girls starting online businesses, and even guys as well, but mostly girls in my program, and just chasing the lack of lifestyle, because this is a true financial freedom, being able to work from anywhere you want and anywhere you are, making money on your phone or when you're sleeping, and that's like the best feeling. Nothing beats that, I'm telling you guys right now, and nothing beats helping your family when you know that they're struggling, or when you can do things for them. Like, I think having money is an amazing resource that we should all strive to work towards, starting side hustles. And maybe you don't want to start a brand, maybe you want to do Amazon, you know, there's so many different side hustles that you can do. Me personally, I tried Amazon and that didn't work for me, but that's not to say that that won't work for you or many other people who have done it. It's a great resource in many ways, but again, building a brand for yourself and starting from scratch, and then being at a place where you actually feel confident and happy, and you know that you won't put your name behind something if it doesn't represent everything that you love. So that's where I am right now, and I'm just really happy to be able to teach that for you guys. And then I'm also just excited for many things to come for the rest of the year, because I have great things coming towards the end of the year, and I'm just really in a place where I'm saving up everything right now for the end of the year, bigger projects. So I'm just excited for everything, and I can't wait for the great things. So I've still been using this Too Faced powder. I actually bought this in LA like last month, and I've still been using it. I'm the color light beige, and I haven't even hit pan with this, but for some reason I've been using it like almost every day, but I haven't hit pan, which is really weird. I was using different powders, so. There's some makeup things that I forgot back at home in Canada, so I definitely need to go buy it. I've also had these crystals lately that I was going to put on my eyes, but then it's like, do I really want to put it on my eyes right now? Let me do my hair first. So I bought my Dyson. I haven't been knowing how to use it fully, but a little bit. Maybe I'll tie my hair up properly and actually do my hair up this time properly. Should I put crystals on my eyes right now? Or should we skip the crystals today? Thank you. Let's see what it looks like if we were to put it on, because I don't really know how I feel about crystals right now. I don't know my outfit either. I'm not sure how I feel because they're like really in your face. I mean, they do give a pop of the eye, so maybe I'll just put it on, and then if I really don't like them later, I will take them off. Yes, okay, I'll put them all on now. Like this, so quite simple. And then I don't know if I'm gonna wear heels tonight, but yeah, this is what we're doing right now. This is what you guys were on, by the way. This is like my little tripod here, considering I don't have a tripod. Yes, I bought all these things new. This is my situation. All right, so I finished filming some TikToks, and then I took a few photos in the sunset. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. I want to show you guys. I'm seeing one of my models later. Look at this view. Oh my gosh, let me get ready to go to dinner, but I can't believe it's so beautiful. I love it. Sometimes, honestly, it's just the simplest things that can literally just change the trajectory of your day. Like, I get sad and then I just look at the sunset or look at the sky and I realize how blessed are we. We are so zoomed in. Oh, there you go. So we're gonna go to dinner and then head out and have some fun. Trying a seafood restaurant, Oyster Bar.
Okay, thank you.
That was so good. Black cod, same fish, right? Yes. Corn, steak. Oh my gosh, this is a gang of food. Hi.